Hi everybody, my name is Troy Sumitomo. I'm the owner of 5-Axis, and behind me is my 1971 Series 1 240Z. I've had this car since the early 90s, and my goal with this vehicle was to make it look like I still had my car from back in the day when I was a kid, and that would be in the 80s. So the one thing I love about this Z is it was, back in the day, it was like the Porsche to me. It was like the slightly out of reach sports car that I've always wanted, but now that I'm older, I was able to find one. And the great thing about this car is that this is actually a very low mileage, all original vehicle when I bought it, and it only had like 43,000 miles on the clock. So the first thing that I was really torn whether to go and do this to it, but what I wanted to do was start with a nice clean slate. And trust me, this car was beautiful to work on because it wasn't dirty underneath, there was no grease, there was, you know, everything was well kept and maintained, and all the screws and fasteners are actually still there. So it was really, like I said, a real pleasure to work on. So the one thing is, because I grew up here in the States, I wanted to make this, I guess like we can call it ADM, but more like American Japanese influences. So what I didn't put the fender mirrors and all that stuff, but I actually got the period correct stuff, like the little baby tornado mirrors, and I got the wink mirrors. I even went as far as to put the tint strip on the front, but not use contact paper like we used to do back in the day. Other things too is, like, I didn't want to flare it because that's more of the JDM style, and also I just couldn't bring myself to punch holes in my fender and stuff. So, but under the hood, I did do what I always wanted to do. I always wanted to have like an old school kind of race motor, which is basically just carbureted, you know, side draft carburetors and stuff. And everything, I tried to keep it all JDM in it. I have Mikuni carburetors and you know, like the intake and all that stuff, they're all Japanese made. But the header was one area that I kind of decided to try something different. And it's a company called Z-Story out of France. But it's all stainless and it was very well fabricated. And the main thing was the welds were really nice and it fit really well, and the price was good, and I really wanted to try it out. So that's the only thing that's not really super JDM. But the one thing that you can't see from here, but underneath the car, there's tons of enhancements done, because I felt the suspension was probably the one area that really needed the most enhancement. And fortunately today, there's a lot of companies making some really nice suspension components. In fact, Tane, who's one of my suspension partners, they make a custom damper that you can actually incorporate into the existing suspension components. So what they did is they take it apart and they put their damper in there. And then as far as some of the other components and stuff, there's a company called T3 or Techno Toy Tuning that makes a lot of really nice billet aluminum pieces for the suspensions, as well as supports for like the rear end and stuff. So that's kind of where I paid a lot of more attention to kind of upgrading the vehicle to more like a resto mod versus the exterior and the interior. If you look on the interior, the one thing that's really cool about it, it's all original. Even the carpets are original, and even the heel pad. I took the mats that were out in there originally out, and the heel pad in there is immaculate. So whoever drove this car really took great care of it. And of course, the great thing is the dashboard is crack-free and stuff. I even go as far as to, you know, use the same car care products I used when I was a kid. Especially the mother's Magna aluminum polish. I think anybody who grew up in the 80s knows that thing. That thing is what put them on the map. And I even use their products today on a lot of cars, you know, on my show cars and stuff. And they have a great ceramic line called CMX. And then they have a speed line, which is really made for just quickly cleaning stuff. So, you know, the main thing was that, like I said, I just wanted people to think I still had my car from the 80s. So, like, and so everything I do with the car, I try to keep it period correct. So one advantage of owning a company like 5-Axis is that my daily thing is building cars. So the great thing was I can easily custom make parts and modify things. Like the wheels, I actually had to take a center out of an existing JDM wheel and then find a barrel that would fit the outside. Also under the hood, there's a lot of custom made parts. I have the little heat shields under the carburetors are all custom made. And even stuff that didn't fit quite right, like the distributor, I had a little bit of a problem getting it to mount, but I was able to make my own bracket. Some of the suspension components, because of the modifications I made, it didn't work. So it was really great to be able to just throw stuff up there and fix it and modify it. So I do have that advantage being in the business that I'm in. Yeah, 5-Axis is a design and prototype shop. I started back in the mid-90s to service the design community. So we've been really fortunate to be aligned with big companies like Toyota, Honda, Lexus, and mainly what we were building was a lot of their concept cars. Probably my two favorite that come to mind are the FT1 and the LFLC. The good advantage of that, like I said, is that I can build things and I have knowledge of fabrication and stuff. So working on an old car like this is a lot of fun. So because I'm so busy all the time, it took me a long time to finish this car, but 2 years ago, before I actually had surgery and I wasn't sure if I was going to be able to drive the car again, I debuted the car at JCCS. Unfortunately, we can't do it this year, but we're looking forward to being able to do it again when everything kind of clears up. I look forward to seeing everybody out at JCCS next year.